Berserk. Now, this is the part where this video series is going to get a little bit better, or I think a lot better personally, because I have a lot to say about this anime, and this is actually kind of current, because I actually finished this anime recently with Trans Angel. I'll say this to start off, this anime is pretty dang violent. It's like talking about Demon Souls. When you're talking about Demon Souls, the first thing you mention is that, wow, this game is hard. Well, the first thing you mention when talking about Berserk is, wow, this game is violent, you know? I'll get more into that as I progress onward with this, you know, thing. And, to start off with, a little bit, again, I got into this series from watching the outtakes on YouTube. They were funny as hell. It was so funny. There were some parts where, like, talking about jacking off, making fun of, like, you know, monster truck announcers. There was even a Goku reference, which I'll have to get to in a minute, and it'll make sense once, I explain things, and Griffith's voice actor would sing songs because he's a singer, so. And so, after that, I rented the first volume DVD from Blockbuster, then I ended up buying it after, you know, the Blockbuster near me closed down. Then I got the remastered DVD set, which I think just came out. And that, you know, thing is pretty nice. And then I watched, you know, the entire series in English with Trans Angel. My favorite character is Guts. I like him because, one, he has a big sword, and you know how I like swords. And I also, and second reason I like him because he's so powerful. Like, he's kind of the Goku of the whole story, how, like, there are strong characters, but ultimately he's the strongest. Like, Guts, if you watch the show, he keeps beating all the people he fights. Except for the exception of, like, one person in the entire anime. And, he's, like, super powerful. As long as, like, he's, like, cursed or gifted at a great fighter. He's sort of an interesting kind of character. He's sort of like a living example of, you know, the mindless soldier that goes out into war. What is going on in that character's mind? That's probably wasn't the creator's intent, but that's a way to look at him. And the third reason why I like him is because I sort of feel sorry for him, and I'll have to get to that. Well, right now, but in order to talk about that reason, I have to talk about another character. Technically the antagonist of the series, Griffith. Now, Griffith is, in my opinion, by far the greatest anime villain I've ever seen. This guy is friggin' evil. This guy is the friggin' devil. He, in a way, he's sort of the Vegeta to Guts' Goku, or the Kuwabara to Guts' Yusuke, or even the Ryuho to Guts' Kazuma, if you really want to go that way. But at the same time, he's not. You know, not only is he the polar, he's also the polar opposite of Guts in many ways. He's, for one thing, smaller than Guts. He's also a little more refined in his training than Guts is. I think Griffith actually had some, like, proper training. He's, like, actually trained to be a fighter, and he's pretty skilled. Well, Guts is more of a barbarian kind of thing. And he also, probably a little more happy and calm and whatnot, while Guts is, like, angry all the freaking time, hence, you know, the name Berserk. That's not the reason why it's called Berserk, but, you know. I'll say this to start off with. Griffith loves, yet hates Guts at the same time. That's ultimately the big thing here. And, that's sort of like a big point that I'm going to bring up several times while talking about this. Thing about Griffith, though, if you pay attention to the first episode of the anime, because the actual anime itself is actually, you know, the prologue, a flashback, to sort of explain the story before it continues on to the actual point of the story. It mentions Griffith twice, talking about how it's like he's the king of Midland now, so, like, he rises up to power and he's a king now, so that shows that, you know, okay, this Griffith character is, you know, important to the story because he's the king. Perhaps, or at least it seems that way once they actually show who Griffith is. And then there's another part where Guts is like, Griffith! And he's thinking about, you know, all the people who have, you know, pissed him off and Griffith being one of them. And so that shows up that, you know, okay, this Griffith character may be a bad guy. Maybe this Guts character is a good guy. He did just save a little girl, so. And that's one way to look at it. But if you miss that, then you're just going to be looking at Griffith as, you know, like I said, the Vegeta of Goku, of Guts' Goku. Or just, you know, just another character. It starts off, you know, It seems like they're best friends, or at least Griffith is trying to be Guts's best friend. He tells Guts that stuff that he wouldn't tell anyone else. He's nice to him. He likes to spend time with him sometimes. He promotes him to like a commander in his army. He's a member, he's like the commander of the Hawks Raiders. Which makes sense, because Guts is like a super powerful Mega Man. Mega Man. But, like I'm saying, this guy is evil. As the series goes on, you don't really get to see it that often. You only get to see it, like, through his eyes. And there's really only one instance where we really get to see how evil he is. But what's more important, in a way, is the relationship between Griffith and Guts, because, like I said, it's a double love, or like a love-hate relationship. You know how Griffith keeps talking about, you know, oh, Guts is so awesome. He's a great person. He's like awesome. He's my buddy. He's a super fighter. And Guts, you know, he's like, oh, okay, he can be my buddy. But then there comes a time, gets to a point where, you know, as, you know, like I said, you know, the whole thing, Griffith rising to power. He wants to be a king. That's sort of his ambitions. He's sort of like a Nobunaga Oda sort of thing, almost, except, you know, in medieval times, I guess, or fantasy times. He wants to be really high in power, and he gets, like, his mercenary band gets hired to, like, work for, like, the kingdom. And they rise up to power pretty dang quickly. The entire series goes by pretty quickly. But yeah. And it gets to a point, you know, the other nobles, they don't like the fact that a common man like Griffith is rising up to power, especially at the fast pace that he's going right now. And so they decide to assassinate him, or they're thinking about it. Well, one person actually tries to go through with it. It's like they're out hunting a fox. And, you know, Guts is, you know, helping out by, you know, effing up the fox's path. Sort of a little bit of a side note, but also helping this discussion or what I'm saying. Griffith, you know, starts to get there's like there's this love affair going on with Griffith and, you know, the princess of Midland, that's the name of the whole place. And he that something sparks up and she likes him and I guess he kind of likes her, but he's trying to be the man about it, you know. And he's trying to teach her how to ride a horseback. Well, the horse she has on goes out of control, and then he chases after her, and that gives the assassinator. That's a cool name, by the way, the assassinator. It gives the assassin a chance to kill Griffith while he's alone with the princess. Only problem is he's risking killing the princess, but you know, I'm sure he's willing to risk that. And so he shoots Griffith in the chest with a poison arrow, and of course he survives because he came prepared, because he, you know, had. He's a smart guy. He probably heard gossiping and whatnot. And, you know, once it came apparent to him that, okay, someone is trying to kill me, he decides to ask Guts to kill that man. And, of course, he's trying to protect himself, you know, and whatnot. So, I mean, of course, he's going to try and, like, kill the person who's trying to stand in his way. In a way, you can think of it as, like, oh, he's not really evil. He's trying to defend himself. Yeah, but, I mean, like, as a soldier wouldn't be like, oh, who cares? I mean, I'm just trying to help these people. But his ambitions, you know, are so strong. He's like, no one will stand in my way. I will kill whoever gets in my way. I am going to friggin' rise to power, and no one's going to stop me. That's sort of another way of looking. But that's not the point I'm trying to make here, especially with this one scene. And guys like, oh, well, you don't even have to ask me. Just give me the order, Captain. He's like, okay, go kill this man. He's like, okay. And so Guts kills the man who, you know, tried to kill him, but his son, or like his nephew or something, I know his son sees him, and out of desperation, Guts kills the son, like stabs him. He's like, I'm here for you, and like whatnot. And the son dies. Well, Guts already feels bad enough that he just killed a kid, and he just friggin' fell down like some sort of little shaft thing or something. He's feeling kind of bad. Well, after going, you know, heading towards like the bar or something to sort of like, I guess, just find a place to calm himself down, he sees Griffith and the princess. I think her name's Rosetta or something. They're talking, and Griffith is like standing up, and he's saying, "A true friend is someone who is equal to me. Anyone who is less than that is not my friend." And he's talking indirectly to Guts. And Guts can tell that. It's like, oh, fuck, this guy doesn't like me. And that may have been because, you know, Guts killed Kid, and Griffith probably saw that as being a lower sort of thing, like something that a weak-minded man would do, or like a truly evil man would do. But that only raises the question, what would Griffith have done in that situation? Would he have killed all the witnesses, including the son? Or would he just jumped out the window and say, fuck it, I don't want to kill a kid, I don't care if I get caught, at least I'm safe. You know, that really raises the question, like, what kind of standards does he have for, you know, assassinating someone who is trying to kill him? Which is why I think this is more of a, no one will stand in my way of my ambitions, rather than, I'm defending myself against someone who's trying to kill me. And, that's a big thing. But then, and then gets to the part where they show how evil he can be. Which is, this is really the only chance in the anime we get to see him being evil until the part where his true colors come out. Another assassination attempt, the assassination attempt is still going on. And he decides, okay, you know what? This is getting annoying. And he finally figures out who he suspects is the head of the whole thing, which is sort of a mini-me kind of character. And he figures that out by, you know, talking to him. And he shows that to the guy that he knows by looking back and doing his famous Griffith Ha-Ike stare at him. He's like, shh. There's even an outtake part where he's like, mini-me, can I have a hug? Because, you know, the guy kind of is bald and short. But, yeah. And so, you know, here's what happens. You know, time goes on, you know, just stuff. And then the bald man, we're just going to call him Mini-Me because that's what Griffith's voice actor called him in the outtake. I don't know what his name is. Gets a letter. And after reading it, he becomes all bent out of shape. And he's like, what the fuck? Oh, great. Oh, no. Something bad. And you can tell that something's going on. Well, as time goes on, like, they finally decide to, you know, go ahead and kill him, including Mini-Me. He's part of him. He's like, let's give him this potion. And, you know, obviously he, you know, brushed it off at that point. He's like, screw the letter. And so he was like, okay, let's kill him. And this is like at the part where, like, Griffith has risen up to, like, almost like a super mega master status. And he is given, you know, the poison drink, and he drinks it. And, you know, he collapses. And then, you know, they move him out, and, you know. But then, they go to the place, he gets up, it turns out that he wasn't even poisoned at all. It was actually switched with something that would just knock him out. So they could move him. He figures out who exactly was behind the whole thing, and he burns down the building that's in them, which ends up killing them all, including the queen. The queen was actually in on this. How did he know this, you asked? Mini-Me. Mini-Me actually ended up helping him out. Let me explain why. You know, he convinced Mini-Me to, you know, okay, I want you to fake my assassination so I can figure out who is behind Oz. He's like, okay. Now, you guys are probably thinking, wait a second, if Mini-Me's trying to kill Griffith, why would he, you know, willingly say, okay, I will help you? I'll tell you why, because Griffith kidnapped his daughter. He kidnapped his daughter. And this is Berserk, so there's no telling what he would have done, you know. That's another thing going by, you know. Thinking, okay, no one's going to get in my way. I will kidnap a little girl if I have to in order to, like, friggin' stay alive to, you know, reach my goals in life. And so he kidnaps Mini-Me's daughter, and I'm assuming they would have killed her. He, of course, gives her back, you know, after the whole thing. He's like, my daughter, thank you. And, you know, it's funny because, like, he's like, oh, there's no ill feelings. We can be friends now. Literally, that's what he says, and he has a smile on his face. And, you know, it's like, oh, wow. And he spares Mini-Me's life, you know? And that, in my opinion, shows the true evil of Griffith at that point. And it says, wow, this guy is so evil. He really wants to be a friggin' king. This guy is evil. But then comes another part which shows this evil, or really starts this whole thing. To first explain things a little bit, Griffith had this bailet around his neck, which was supposed to help him get supreme power. But it turns out that it was actually, you know, a big problem like. And